inspirational anthems, Billboard number one hits, coming-of-age classics, and dance floor bops. During Pride Month, queer anthems are impossible to escape. But what makes a song gay? And what are the history of some of Billboard's biggest LGBTQ+ classics?
Hey, I'm Haley Kiyoko, and this is Billboard Explains Queer Anthems of Pride.
How does a song become a gay anthem? Like the LGBTQ+ community itself, the soundtrack is vast and diverse. Gay forerunners, divas, and allies that have made possible the positive changes we've seen over the decades, from clubs and ballrooms to Broadway shows and more. While it's impossible to define exactly what makes a song gay, Billboard is breaking down a list that definitely isn't straight, and it almost always mirrors the struggles of self-acceptance and social rejection. Let's start with the classics. One of the first songs to capture the audience was Over the Rainbow by Judy Garland, but it was the 1970s that had bands really make an impact. ABBA turned everybody into a dancing queen, while Queen frontman Freddie Mercury begged for somebody to love. Freddie passed away to AIDS, and to this day, their music remains a staple in the culture. The 80s saw the ladies give everyone what they wanted. The Weather Girls reminded us. Sister Sledge said that no matter what, and did you really come out of the closet if you didn't play Diana Ross's disco hit, I'm Coming Out? The 90s, it was time to make it happen. Mariah Carey's signature track appealed to one of gay anthem's biggest traits, an uplifting message that appeals to the queer club scene. Madonna's Vogue gave choreography to that very scene. And TLC spread HIV awareness in a Billboard hit. The 2000s saw pop stars encouraging a new generation of queers to feel accepted. You are beautiful in every single way. The 2010s brought anthems from Britney, Ariana Grande, Kesha, and Katy Perry. Baby, you're a fire. Female allies, straight or queer, tend to give the energy the LGBTQ+ community feels inside that's bursting to come out. Step on my gown, you need to calm down. That also happens with musicals. From Barbra Streisand's Don't Rain on My Parade to the moving story of Rent, Elsa telling us to let it go, and did Disney's We Don't Talk About Bruno become a drag queen anthem? Musicals tap into a place where the LGBTQ+ community sometimes feel the most free, the arts. And we couldn't finish without talking about the gay icons that continue to pave the way with their honest music. David Bowie and Elton John broke boundaries before most knew they needed to be broken. Adam Lambert famously caused controversy kissing a man on stage after American Idol fame, but now alongside Queen has helped pave the way for many queer artists today. And let's not forget Lil Nas X, who carried the torch most recently in 2021 at the BET Awards. Troy Sivan told a gay love story with the Blue Neighborhood trilogy and told us what it was like to bloom. Hayley Kiyoko is known to her fans as Lesbian Jesus.
As an artist, you hope to create music that make people feel seen and heard. Girls are like
girls. Kim Petras has given us Spooky Pop and Slut Pop. And Tegan and Sarah's Closer gives the rawness the community craves. This June and every year, these anthems make us feel brave. Make us cry. And they will forever make us dance.